Any non-Muslim would like to ask, they are most welcome. Please do not feel shy to ask any question on Islam and comparative religion, on the topic women's rights in Islam, whether it's about Quran, whether it's against us, no problem, I can take it.
Sir, this question is from a non-Muslim sister. She is present in the audience, but for security reasons, she will not like to come on the microphone. I'll be reading her question.
Welcome.
If a non-Muslim girl wants to marry a Muslim boy, and the Muslim boy asks the girl to convert, not by force, but because he wishes her to accept the religion, is it wrong? Meaning, is it wrong on the part of the boy to ask to convert? Secondly, if a non-Muslim girl marries a Muslim boy without converting, but still follows the Islamic religion as it is supposed to be followed, is it wrong on the part of the girl to follow the religion but without converting? Her name is Khushbu. She is a teacher by profession.
Sister asked the question that the non-Muslim had to ask a question, that can a non-Muslim girl, if she wants to marry a Muslim boy and the Muslim boy requests her to accept Islam, is it right? And if a non-Muslim girl follows Islam without converting, is it acceptable? The Quran says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 221, that do not marry unbelieving women until they believe. Do not marry a mushrika until they believe. Because it further says that it is preferable to marry a believing woman even if she is a bondwoman, even if she may be a servant, even if she may be ugly. It is far superior to marry a believing woman who is a bondwoman rather than an unbelieving woman, even if she attracts you. She may be the most beautiful woman, she may be a beauty queen, she may be the wealthiest woman, but a believing woman is far superior. So in terms of, is it right for a Muslim man to ask the non-Muslim woman to convert before marrying? It is not right, it is a must. Without she accepting Islam, he cannot marry her. Coming to your second question, that why, I'll tell you. For example, if I tell you that there is a car, one tire is of a cycle and the other is of a tractor, will the car run? No. All the tires should either be of a bicycle, you'll have a handcuff. At least, or of a tractor, you'll have a proper tractor. Because when you're leading a life, the views and philosophies, the major thing, the goal of Jannah should be same. Coming to your second question, that if a woman follows the teachings of Islam but does not convert, is it acceptable? See, for conversion, you don't have to publicly announce. You don't have to come on the microphone and say, I bear witness that there's no God but Allah. It's not a must. If you feel your life is in danger, if you say within your hearts and tell it to Almighty God, you don't even require any witness. It is between you and Allah. So there is no particular ceremony that is required. But proclaiming is preferable so that the people in the world don't misunderstand you. But if you feel your life is in danger, if you proclaim to Allah only and keep it in your heart and follow, Alhamdulillah. Following is more important than proclaiming. It is preferable for the lady not to mention but yet follow Islam than to mention she has converted and not follow Islam. Have you heard my answer? It is preferable for a non-Muslim woman to practice Islam without proclaiming rather than proclaim and not practice Islam. Practicing is more important than proclaiming. It is between her and Allah.
Peaceful.
So the moment she starts practicing Islam, it's understood when she offers Salah, she agrees there is one Allah and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger. The moment you say Akama, it is in that Akama you believe that there is no God but Allah and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger. Finish. So if she starts practicing, she doesn't have to proclaim also. So if she wants to do the second, practicing is more important than proclaiming. But if she wants to proclaim, it is fine, she can proclaim. Hope that answers the question.